This is Richard Wolff from Democracy at Work responding to another Ask Prof. Wolff question from our Patreon community. And this one comes from Karan. And Karan asks the question, what would a school system, from the elementary all the way up to college, what would a school system look like if we had a society in which production was organized in the form of worker co-ops, rather than in the capitalist top-down way that we are used to? What would it mean? And would it be different in terms of what it aims to achieve, rather than fitting us all into the capitalist system as workers or managers or owners? What would be the alternative objectives of such a system? Well, you know, this question comes up often, and I'm very glad that Karan asked it and that I have a chance to sketch what an answer would look like. The most important thing is to say that education would no longer be subordinated to the role of reproducing capitalism. And let me explain briefly what I mean. It's not just teaching the ideas that capitalism is the greatest gift since sliced bread. And it's not just that capitalism is presented as efficient and fair and all of those obvious ideological things, which our education system in the US certainly does. It's not so much that, it's the more subtle ways that capitalism subordinates education. Think how many times you've heard an official in the educational system talk about running the school, quote, in a business-like manner. What an awful idea. Or think about what it means that we organize schools with the workers, the teachers, the clerics, the janitors, subordinated to a tiny group of administrators at the top. So I remind you of how most capitalist businesses work. That's what it should remind you of. And think also of the number of times people have advocated this or that educational policy because it's better preparing our young people for the jobs that are out there. What a way to serve capitalism. It's an organization to recruit and train whatever they need. And we know that what businesses need is governed by the profit motive that is uppermost in the minds of businesses, their bottom line. So how would it be different? Very quickly, here we go. Number one, it would be different because it wouldn't be organized a school anyway in that top-down business-like way. It would be organized as a community with collectives working together. The collective of the teachers, the collective of the other workers alongside the teachers, a collective of the students, even the youngest ones, and then a collective of the public, the parents and the larger community. The ones making the daily decisions would be the teachers and the other workers in the school. Notice what I've left out. No administrators. The schools can and should be self-administrating. They can work out who among them, temporarily or permanently, does administrative work. But it comes out of the community. It is responsible to the community. Democracy rules. Yes, there'll be different kinds of participation. Young children will be limited in one way. Non-teachers will be different from teachers. All of that is understandable and will be well understood in such schools. But they'll be organized as democratic communities. And that's a far better way to educate people to be democratic citizens than the very undemocratic way schools are organized now. And will they be training everyone for a job? No. Jobs in a society of the sort we imagine are guaranteed. They're part of your human right, like going to a park and accessing a beach or any of the other socially universal things we do. Guaranteeing a job and income is one of the first things to make people truly free? Ask them, they'll tell you. So it'll be a very different system. It'll be training people for democracy, for community, for working out together in whatever institution, a school, a workplace, anything else. Participate, democracy, cooperative work. That'll be the goal of creating new citizens in a school system that was organized around worker co-ops as the basic idea. If interventions like this strike you as interesting and useful, and that they ought to be part of the national conversation about society, about education, about our schools, then please partner with us. Share the video. Show it to friends, neighbors, other parents in the school system near you, that kind of thing. That's a way to extend our reach. And you know, another way is to do something that costs nothing. It involves going to YouTube and looking us up, our channel, Democracy at Work, and signing up, little button to press, no money to pay, to become a subscriber. And all that means is you'll hear about all the work that we do, and you'll become a partner in that work, and that's how we extend our reach. So from all of us at Democracy at Work, thank you.